For mitosis, each chromosome makes an exact duplicate of themselves. The chromosomes then thicken and coil within the nucleus. Next, in early prophase, the centrioles that have divided form asters and move apart. The nuclear membrane begins to disintegrate. In late prophase, the centrioles and asters are at the opposite poles. The nucleolus and nuclear membrane have almost disappeared. The double chromosomes, or their centromeres, attached to the spindle fibers, line up at the equator in metaphase. During early anaphase, the centromeres split. Half the chromosomes move to the one pole, half to the other side. The cell membrane then completes construction in telophase. Nuclear membranes form around the separated chromosomes to protect them. Mitosis is now completed. There are two daughter cells with the same structures and number of chromosomes as the parent cell. Beginning of meiosis, DNA strands thicken into chromosomes. Homologous chromosomes begin to approach each other. Homologous chromosomes pair to form bivalents. Then the centrioles divide and move to the opposite sides of the cell. These same bivalents duplicate to form tetrads, or form chromatid groups. The nuclear membrane disintegrates, crossing over occurs. Metaphase 1, the tetrads line up at the mid-cell, attached to spindle fibers at their centromeres. Early in anaphase 1, the tetrads then separate and the paired chromatids move along the spindles to their centrioles. In late anaphase 1, the cell membrane begins to constrict because the chromatids have almost reached the spindle poles. The first division ends. There are now two daughter cells with the same number of chromatids as the parent cell. The two daughter cells undergo the same process again until they begin to split. This is anaphase 2. Telophase 2 has been completed. There are now four daughter cells, and they each have half the number of chromosomes of the parent cell.